गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, दिस इज रिविजन लेक्चर ऑफ केमिकल काइनेटिक्स. सो वी हैव स्टडीड टिल नाउ केमिकल काइनेटिक्स. सो वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज वॉट एवर आई टॉट यू टिल नाउ. वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज दिस. सो फर्स्ट इज वेन एवर वी एक्सप्रेस रेट एनी केमिकल रिएक्शन इज देयर in which reactant A converts into product P, then rate is given as R equals to minus concentration of A divided by dt. This is rate with respect to reactant A. Rate with respect to product is written as R equals to plus concentration of product divided by time. Meaning of this is rate is equals to change in concentration of reactant per unit time as well as change in concentration of product per unit time, both gives rate of reaction. Now there are two types of rate, instantaneous rate and average rate. Whenever I say average rate, then average rate is equals to final concentration of reactant minus initial concentration of reactant divided by time interval T2 minus T1. This gives average rate of reaction and with negative sign. Whenever we have to convert this into instantaneous reaction, we have to take very small time interval, very small change in concentration of reactant. For that we use the limit, and limit is, this we can write delta A minus divided by delta T, and if you use the limit, then this limit R will be equal to minus limit delta T tends to 0. Very small time interval, concentration of change in concentration of A divided by dt. We know that when we take limit delta T tends to 0, then this can be written as minus dA by dt. Here this rate R is called instantaneous rate because it tells us about the rate of reaction at any particular instant. This is the exact rate of reaction, while this one is average rate of reaction. Whenever reaction starts, reactant starts to convert into product, then over the time concentration of A will start to decrease, concentration of product will start to increase. But this rate of reaction will not be uniform throughout the time interval. In the beginning, rate of reaction may be fast, after then rate of reaction may be slow, like that. So whenever we calculate average rate of reaction, this gives us idea about the rate of reaction over a particular time interval. But when we calculate instantaneous rate of reaction, it gives us rate of reaction at a particular instant. For example, whenever you ride bike and you go from your home to market, then from home to market you possesses different speed. In the beginning you may run your bike with 60 km per hour, but when there is traffic your speed may decrease to 20 km per hour, and sometimes you may come at rest. But if we calculate overall rate, that is average rate, then we calculate it by dividing the total distance traveled divided by total time, and that if comes suppose 20 km per hour, this is not the exact speed, this is not your exact speed. 20 km per hour is not your exact speed, it is an average speed. Whenever we talk about the instantaneous speed, in case of instantaneous speed, this speed, in this speed delta T becomes to 0, time interval becomes very very small. In that case, whatever we calculate, that is called instantaneous. So like instantaneous speed, there is instantaneous rate of reaction, and for the instantaneous rate of reaction, delta T must be very small, that we write in terms of limit, it tends to 0. We should not infer that delta T will be equal to 0, it should be tends to 0, means time interval will be very very small. That at that time we'll write rate equals to minus dA upon dt. Now suppose for any hypothetical chemical reaction in which alpha moles of A reacts with beta mole of B, giving gamma mole of C plus delta mole of D. In this case, we write rate expression R equals to minus 1 by alpha dA divided by dt. This will be rate with respect to A. Rate with respect to B will be R equals to minus 1 by beta concentration of dB divided by dt. Rate with respect to C will be R equals to minus 1 by gamma concentration change in concentration of C divided by dt. But here negative sign will not be there, positive sign will be, because this is product, change in concentration of product will be always a positive value, while change in concentration of reactant will be negative value. That's why whenever we write rate expression for reactant, we put here negative sign, and whenever we write rate expression in terms of change in concentration of product, then we write here positive sign. Now next is R equals to plus 1 by delta change in concentration of D divided by dt. So these are rate of reaction. This is a chemical reaction in which reactant A is reacting with B giving C and D. Whether we calculate rate with respect to A, B, C and D, all rates will be equal. So we can write here, R equals to minus 1 by alpha dA by dt equals to minus 1 by beta dB by dt equals to plus 1 by gamma dC by dt equals to plus 1 by delta dD by dt. This is the expression for rate. Rate equals to minus 1 by alpha. Alpha is what? Alpha is stoichiometric coefficient of reactant A in balanced chemical equation. Whenever we write any chemical reaction, in that we have to see what is the stoichiometric coefficient of A or any reactant in that balanced chemical equation. So alpha is stoichiometric coefficient. Similarly, beta is also here stoichiometric coefficient. Gamma is also stoichiometric coefficient. Delta is also stoichiometric coefficient. So rate equals to minus 1 by alpha dA by dt with respect to A. With respect to B, minus 1 by beta dB by dt. With respect to C, plus 1 by gamma dC by dt. And with respect to D, plus 1 by delta dD by dt. These are the rate of reaction. But here one of the important thing that you have to remember, that when someone says rate of disappearance, of A, sometimes question is asked, what is rate of disappearance of A? This whole term is rate of reaction. But this term is rate of disappearance of A, because over the time A is disappearing, B is disappearing, and C and D is appearing, or formation of C and D is taking place. So we can write rate of disappearance of A equals to dA by dt. So dA by dt will be the rate of disappearance of A. Similarly, dB by dt will be the rate of disappearance of B, and dC by dt will be the rate of formation of C, and dD by d will be rate of formation of D. So sometime question comes, what is the rate of formation of particular reactant? In that case, don't calculate this whole value. Question is only asking you about dA by dt. Now we will see law of mass action. This is classical law for the determination of rate of reaction. This law says that for any chemical reaction in which reactant A is converting into product, rate will be directly proportional to active mass of A. Here active mass of A means concentration of A. So we can write here rate equals to, suppose here alpha is there, alpha A is converting into beta P, then we will write rate R equals to concentration of A to the power alpha, or we may also write like this, R is directly proportional to concentration of A to the power alpha. So how we can define law of mass action? Law of mass action says that rate of any chemical reaction is directly proportional to the concentration of reactant or directly proportional to the active mass of the reactant. Active mass term was used in classical chemistry because there at that time concentration term was not well defined. So at that time, instead of using concentration term, they used to say active mass in place of concentration. So we can write rate is directly proportional to concentration of A to the power alpha. So the statement of law of mass action is rate of any chemical reaction is directly proportional to concentration of reactant raised to the power equal to its stoichiometric coefficient. So law of mass action, we can write rate of chemical reaction is directly proportional to concentration of reactant raised to power equal to stoichiometric coefficient of reactant. After then, on advancement in this field in chemistry, another law came that is known as rate law. It is simply known as rate law. Rate law says that same statement is there, any reactant A is there, and this reactant A converts into product P. Alpha A converts into product beta P. Then here rate will write rate equals to concentration, rate is directly proportional to concentration of A to the power M, where M may be equal to alpha or may not be equal to alpha. So here contradiction comes. Rate law says that for any chemical reaction, rate of reaction is directly proportional to the concentration of reactant raised to a power which may or may not be equal to the stoichiometric coefficient. So why this was? Actually, in law of mass action, they were only considering that concentration part, but on advancement, on further experiment and study, it was found that rate of reaction depends on concentration, that is correct, but it depends on power M also. That power M is called order of reaction, and this order of reaction may be equal to stoichiometric coefficient or may not be equal to stoichiometric coefficient. There is no hard and fast rule that this M will always be equal to alpha. According to law of mass action, this M was always equal to alpha, but in rate law, this M may be equal to alpha or may not be equal to alpha. So this is rate law. So what the statement of rate law is, in any chemical reaction, rate of reaction is directly proportional to concentration of reactant raised to some power that may be equal to stoichiometric coefficient or may not be equal to stoichiometric coefficient. That power is called order of reaction. So here M is equal to, here M is equal to order of reaction. We can write here M equals to order of reaction. So in class 12 we have to study following order, basic zero order and first order. Second order reaction is not there in your syllabus, so we'll only focus on zero order and first order reaction. So starting with zero order reaction, zero order reaction, suppose any chemical reaction is there in which reactant A converts into product P. A is our reactant, P is our product. Then if you write rate, then rate can be written as minus dA by dt, that is rate of change of concentration of A is rate of reaction. And from rate law we can write, if you write rate law, then we can write from rate law R equals to concentration of A to the power M, where M is order of reaction, K is rate constant. K is equals to rate constant and M equals to order of reaction. So if we put here, this is a zero order reaction. If we put the value of m zero, then we'll get r equals to k a to the power zero. And we know that zero power on any numerical value will give 1. So we'll have here r equals to k. So in zero order reaction, rate of reaction is equal to rate constant. This is very important point, that in case of zero order reaction, rate of reaction is equal to rate constant. Sometimes question comes like that, they say that there is a zero order reaction whose rate constant is some value is given with unit. What will be the rate of reaction? Then a student get confused and get puzzled that no values are given, only rate constant is given, concentration is not given, time interval is not given, then how we should find the rate of reaction? So you have to remember this point, that in case of zero order reaction, rate of reaction is always equal to rate constant, because you can see that on concentration term power is zero, and zero power on any numerical value will give 1, so r equals to k. Now if we see here r equals to k, and here we have r equals to minus dA by dt. So if we suppose this one as reaction first, and this one as this one is equation first and this one is equation second, then we can equate these two equation, first and second, and on equating we'll get k equals to minus dA by dt. If we cross multiply, then we'll get k into dt equals to minus dA. Now on integrating both side, if we integrate both side, on integrating both side, we'll get integration of k. K is a constant, and we know that constant cannot be integrated. So we'll write here k, and here we'll write dt equals to integration of dA. As this is not indefinite integral, this is definite integral, there is certain time interval. It is not possible that we have started reaction and that reaction will observe throughout our life. There will be certain time interval, that is 1 hour, 2 hour, 3 hour, 1 day, 2 day, 3 day, 4 day, whatever time is there, there will be certain time interval. It is not possible for us to observe a chemical reaction throughout the life. So for that we will put here limit, and limit is, for simplicity I write t initial minus t final. It depends upon the observer, whatever time he is using to observe a particular chemical reaction. And here I write initial concentration and final concentration, AI to AF. If we integrate this, then we'll get on integration KT, integration of DT will be T, KT equals to, KT will be equal to dA, will convert into A, and we'll put here limit A initial to A final. So this will be our unit, limit will be A, initial limit, and then final limit. So K into T equals to concentration of A, A initial to A final, and here limit will be T initial to T final. Now we can see that we can write here, we can put the limit, that limit will be T final minus T initial, and if we put here limit, then we'll have negative sign will maintain, that will be equal to negative sign A final minus A initial. So here K into T equals to, if we multiply this negative sign, then we'll have minus A final plus A initial. So we can write here minus A final equals to KT minus A initial, or A final equals to minus KT plus A initial. If we see this equation, then it is following Y equal to mx plus c relationship, where m is rate constant, time is another variable x, and c is intercept on y axis.